Learning Style from Mr. Excel Podcast, episode 2380. Look ahead when selecting names. Hey, welcome back to the Mr. Excel Netcast. I'm Bill Jelen. This is an eternal problem that we've always had, that you can set up data validation, but there's no good way to get through this list quickly. Like, you can't use the mouse, the wheel mouse. You can't type the first few letters of what you're looking for. You're just stuck unless you scroll. And a cool trick here from Bob Umless that he got from his friend Alfred. Let me show you how it's working. Let me show you how it's working first. It's actually very satisfying how it works. Alfred came up with this to select a name. First thing we're gonna do is type an equals and then a backslash, equals and backslash. And then it gives us this whole big list. And the beautiful thing is, if we know that we want someone who starts with a J, I start to type the J and the list shortens to everyone who starts with a J. And I'll type an A and I get just the JAs, JAV, all right, there's Javier. And now that I have that name, I can just press tab, enter, and I'm done. All right, let's try someone in the C's. So equal backslash C, and then E, all right, tab, enter, equal backslash Y. Oh yeah, there's a couple of those. And I can use the up or down arrow keys to choose, right? It actually works pretty well. It's a cool trick. So let's go back to my original workbook and I'll show you how to set this up. Our names are over here in column A. I'm gonna insert a new column to the left of that and we're gonna use concatenation. So equal sign, quote, backslash, end quote, ampersand, the name over in the column B, like that. And we're gonna do that so we can get a list of what eventually will become range names. So I choose those names and their values. And then here on the formulas tab, I'm gonna use create name from selection. And it always chooses top row. We're gonna uncheck that and say that everything in the left row, left column, is gonna name the cell to the right of it. So this cell, B5, it's gonna be called backslash Alberto Cromwell. And it'll just happen automatically. So click okay, right? And bam, we just created a couple hundred names. And now the beautiful thing is, we don't have to use data validation in any cell. We can just come here, equal sign, backslash, type of K, E, Keanu, right? It actually is much faster, I think, than data validation. Now, one hassle here is we created, you know, in this case, 200 names. Is that a problem? I don't think it's any worse than having 200 data validation boxes in a whole range, and it's great. It'll just work anywhere you want it to work. So pretty cool trick. Thanks to Bob Umless for sending that along. And to his friend Alfred for figuring that out. Hey, if you like these tips, please down below click like, subscribe, and ring the bell. Feel free to post any questions or comments down in the comments below. Check out Bob Umless's book, Excel Outside the Box. There's also more Excel Outside the Box. That I in the top right hand corner will take you to a link where you can read more about the book. I want to thank you for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another Netcast from Mr. Excel.